Hello, and welcome back to my course on learning commands in Minecraft. My name is slicedlime, and last time we learned the repeat command block mode and the set block command. Today, we'll move on to the third command block mode. The final mode you can put a command block in is called chain. To explain this, we have to take a look at the actual appearance of the command blocks. This far, we've simply been putting commands into them and running them, but if you look a bit closer, you can see that the blocks actually have a direction, as shown by the arrow on the sides and the shapes on the front and the back. Now let's say we want to run several commands in a row. Of course, we could put a button on each one, but that's pretty tedious for the player of our map. Or we could put a redstone line connected to all of them, but what if the order the commands get run in is important? The answer to all of this is command block chains. When an impulse or repeating command block triggers, it will first run its own command, then look for any chain command block on the side of the block the arrow is pointing towards, its backside. If it finds one, it'll run that too. And then that one does the same thing, continuing in, as the name implies, a chain. You can have quite a few blocks in a single chain like that. While there are some limits, we won't really get anywhere near them until we get really advanced, so don't worry about them for now. We'll get back to that in a much later lesson. So let's say that we want to set more than one block from our repeating command block over here, which is still running, by the way. We can do that by adding on a chain command block afterwards and setting it to always active. Otherwise, it'll require a redstone signal to run, remember? Now, we'll enter a second set block command here for an emerald block, right above the gold block, and we can see that immediately we now have both of these blocks being set every single tick. Within the context of the tick, the gold block is actually being set first, and the order of commands will turn out very important down the line. For this simple example, it doesn't really matter though. We get both a gold block and an emerald block every tick. Here's a slightly more complicated example. We've got an impulse command block set to needs redstone signal to activate, and a whole line of chain command blocks all set to always active. Notice how the chain is turning, snaking its way back and forth. We can do that because each block in turn looks for the next block in the way it's pointed, which lets us turn the chain whenever we want. Let's press the button. All the commands now activate, painting this nice blocky heart on the floor. Before we move on to explain what else happened, please take a moment to show some love for this video by hitting the like button. That helps spread its love across all of YouTube, so I'd really appreciate the help. Thank you. Now, something else also happened when I activated this command chain, which is our first new command for today. The teleport or TP command. Both forms work exactly the same. TP is simply a shorter way to type in teleport. There are many fairly complex forms of this command, but we'll look at the most basic one here. Teleport, followed by a target, in this case myself, then a set of coordinates. As the name implies, this moves the player from wherever I was in the world to a position so that my feet end up standing exactly at the coordinates in the command, which in this case is the center of the heart. Keep in mind that you really do end up with your feet exactly where those coordinates were, so if you're using the autocomplete function to type in the coordinates, you want to be pointing at the top of a block, not the side of it. Teleporting inside of blocks usually means you end up either with a blocked view or falling out the bottom of them. If you do end up inside a block, don't worry, we've got a command to help you out. Changing your game mode to spectator mode makes it easy to fly out of whatever blocks you've ended up inside. Then you can switch modes back. This is done with the gamemode command. Let's try it out by typing in /gamemode spectator. We're now able to fly around and look at whatever we want, even if that means flying through blocks. There are four game modes: survival and creative, which you're most likely familiar with, spectator, which is this mode where you don't really interact with the world, you're just watching, or as one might say, spectating. The final mode is Adventure, in which you have a physical form and can do some things, like fight mobs, but not other things, like break blocks. We'll get back to Adventure mode in a later episode. If you want your game mode to be changed as part of a command block chain, that is also possible, but since the command block doesn't know who to change the game mode for, you'll need to tell it by adding your name as a target to the end of the command line. There's a quicker way to switch modes too. Hold down the F3 button and tap the F4 button, and then keep holding down F3. This brings up the game mode selector menu. You can then press F4 again to cycle through the modes or use the mouse to select one. When you're done, release the F3 button and you'll be switched into that mode. And in the background, this is simply running the command, just like if you had typed it in. Of course, the game mode selector only works if you're switching modes yourself, not if you're changing someone else's mode or doing it as part of a command block chain. And that's enough for today. We've now made it through quite a lot of the very basics of Minecraft commands, with the set block, give, game rule, teleport, and game mode commands, as well as the repeat and chain command block modes. Make sure you grab the companion map and go through the exercises there to get some practice with these commands. And of course, feel free to experiment with even more commands on your own.